This video will show you how to make a footnote style citation in Chicago format. So I've got a bibliography entry for a source here, and I've got a quote from my source, and I know the page number that it was on. But then the next step is, you know, how do I write the footnote? Well, you can use a website like Owl Purdue to help you format your footnotes. But something that a lot of people don't realize, when you're looking at this footnote citation example on Owl Purdue, that example is for how to write the citation if you don't have a bibliography page. If you're using footnotes or endnotes as the only way of citing your sources, you need all this information about the name of the journal, the volume, the year, and all that stuff. But if you look over here on this other page at Owl Purdue where it's introducing the format, it tells you you don't need the full publication information in your footnote. If you have a bibliography page, you can use a shortened one with the author's last name, a short version of the title, and the page number of your quote. Okay, so let's take a look at our paper again. So let's add a footnote. So if we open up the References tab in Microsoft Word, we can click Insert Footnote, and it'll do that automatically. And we can type the author's last name. Since there's two authors for this source, we use both their names, a short version of the title, and that was from page number 108, a period. So commas after the author and after the title and a period at the end. Now let's go back up here to the quote. So in Chicago style, we don't need the page number here because we've got it down at the bottom. And since we took out the citation, the period should go inside the quotation mark. So period, quotation mark, then your footnote. Now, let's look at the formatting of the footnotes themselves. So we'll scroll to the bottom of the page here. Now, in theory, you would like to have a full number with a period after it instead of a superscript number. That is actually very difficult to get Microsoft Word to do that, and it doesn't usually matter for a student paper, so we don't worry too much about that. You can see that this is in Calibri font, but the rest of my paper is in Times New Roman, so I'll change that to Times New Roman. And you'll want to put an extra space between your citations. So rather than having them single spaced, we can put an extra space between them. And we can do that from the Home tab and go to Paragraph. So you want them to be single spaced within them. Like if you had a citation that was very long, you'd want it to wrap to the next line. But you do want to add an extra space after the paragraph. So I put 10 point in here because we're using 10 point as the font, and that'll make it like double spaced, but only between the citations and not within them if you had a long one. We will also want to indent the footnotes. So we can actually go back to the paragraph tab. There's a few different ways we can do this. And where it says left indentation, we can put 0.5 inches to indent that automatically, and that scoots them over just a bit. Okay, so we've got the footnote we added from the reference tab. We type the author's last name, a short version of the title, and the page number of the quote, and then we changed the font. We made sure that the spacing between paragraphs was good, and we indented them 1/2 inch. I hope that helps. Thanks.